Hello vinyl community. So another video, another tag. I would hazard that quite a few of the people who follow this channel are familiar with Norman Maslow, Mazzy. He recently launched a new tag, the folk tag 2021. And at first I thought like, okay, like, I don't have that much folk. Yeah, I have a few Bob Dylan and stuff. And then I thought, of course, I have tons of folk music. I have hundreds of records in so many different directions. So so here it is. This works like that. Like Mazzy put a list of categories, 20. Categories, questions, and you show a record. I will play for the most part, so it will be quite a long video, but I think it should be worth your while. So here it is, the first category. A folk record from before, from the 50s.
Now I know that King Edward, he was noble and great, but his love would cause him to abdicate. It was love, it's love alone that caused King Edward to leave his throne. Now I know that my mommy, she is going to grieve, but I cannot help it, for I'm bound to leave. It was love, it's love alone that caused King Edward to leave his throne. Tamarilla, Tamarola, here upon my mind, I say I cannot leave Miss Simpsons behind. It was love, it's love alone that caused King Edward to leave his throne.
Tony Schwartz did quite a few records for Folkways, the best label in the history of labels. He mostly did field recordings around New York of the harbor streets, and this is a compilation of street musicians recorded live in the streets, featuring probably the very first recording of Moondog. Moondog was recorded in the doorway of 52nd Street between 6th and 7th Avenues. We're currently listening to Ralph Rinsler and the Kosoi Twins' King Edward. The Kosoi Twins are a duo of women folk singers, pretty good. This is more on the calypso side of things, but it is still.
On the 10th of December, you all heard the talk when they gave.
And yeah, lots of unknown musicians that were probably only recorded on this instance. This was released in 58 or 59, I believe. So yeah, pretty good shape for such a an oldie. Yeah, Folkways always had these fold artwork with a booklet. Yeah, I'll just play quickly a little bit of the Kosoi Twins. This is really, really a good album. So next, a category where this record could have already also competed in. An archival or field recording. Now I'm going a little bit outside the expectations, probably. This is one of my absolute favorite records. One record I bought 5-6 times. Always. Whenever I find a copy, I get it. It will always be a great present. This is actually also the source of inspiration for a project I have, which has prompted me to learn some basics of Kirungi, the official language of Burundi. This is an Okora Radio France release, musique traditionnelle du Burundi. This is the ladder press. I have the first press somewhere, but yeah, well. So this sounds almost like Tom Waits. It's singing on a sitar, African sitar, or Burundi sitar. And this is stunning. This was recorded in 1967, and there's so much variety. The male singing. You also get stuff like that. That was actually pretty inspiring for early 90s electronic music, from my experience. Yeah, so I guess a lot of people expect like Western person singing in English with a guitar when you say folk, but well, this is even more folk music than anything coming out of the usual bag of tricks, I would say. And well, that's it. That was the recording, field recording archival. Next, a folk record post 2010, so a recent release. There we go. Six organs of admittance. This is the work of Ben Chasny. He has a few records, but this one is quite different from the rest of his production. All music composed using the ecstatic system, which is a very specific tuning system. That is pretty awesome. This was released in 2015 on Drag City. There's two volumes of this, but this one is by far the best. Drag City, so it might still be in print and possible to get it directly from the label. Ecstatic 2, yeah. Stunning stuff. Next, a fave male folk singer. All right. Getting closer to home, let's go to Sweden. Pug Rogefeld. This is his debut album. Yes, it is it. On Metronome, great Swedish label. A booklet explaining a little bit of it. There was a huge folk, hippie, spiritual jazz movement in Sweden in the 60s, 70s. And this guy became quite a star with a very special singing voice, you'll hear. Metronome, ja.
Smålen varmål, se jag på din himmel som är blå. Här är du nu min sommar, med smålet varmål. Min kärlek har du sommar, din himmel som blå. Smågröna blad, se jag på din hud är blomstersprut. Nu kommer då min sommar, med smågröna blad.
The song is called Small light clouds, small light clouds. And he sings about how these make him so happy. I guess because it's in Swedish and the voice is so special, he didn't cross too many borders, but here in Sweden it was huge. It's such a beautiful album. Rockfield. Oh, he sings acoustic guitar, electric guitar, with Gorg Vadenius on bass, guitar, piano, drums, or perks, and Jan Karlsson on drums. Now, favorite female singer. A record I already showed. Record really dear to me, Emmanuel Paronin.
Mais ses manières n'étaient pas franches et son cœur pas soir au fond de ses yeux pervenches.
Like psych hippie avant folk, recorded with Bruno Mini, electronics treatments. And this song is done, written and arranged by Jean-Claude Vanier, the arranger of Serge Gainsbourg.
Il avait plus d'un tour dans sa manche au fond de son tiroir.
Such a great album.
Il a fallu que son cœur se penche vers d'autres perchoirs.
So Pink Harps.
Adieu baiser, mais en revanche, au fond de
Emmanuel Paronin, who's going to release a new album this year that is highly anticipated. Song is called White Feather, Black Feather. She's not known at all in France. She's totally underground, but she's starting to get a global appreciation by music critics and
enthusiasts. On verra sa maison blanche, mon pauvre saint noir, plus blanche, plus noire, 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 plus blanche, plus noire.
Next, a duo or trio of folk music. So I'll go with Matt Valentine and Erica Eder, who are a huge favorite of mine, we're listening to their project, the Tower Recordings. So, gatefold, silk screen. So this is the duo with some guests, the futuristic folk of the Tower Recordings. Such a good record. Currently listening to a song called Taste of Moon. It's a Mad Valentine Spectra sound. I think in the early 2000s, stunning stuff, really like psychedelic hippie noise. They've got tons of great records. Here's another Tower Recordings. Yeah, more Tower Recordings. This is Matt and Erika together. Matt Valentine and Erika at their medicine show. I just got so many. And of course there's like Indian music influence in this. The tuning, the whole imagery. Yeah, it's great stuff. Yeah, this goes on for such a long time. I think at one point there was like a scene of folk music called the Freak Folk or something, and I think that were kind of some of the heralds of this, even if this is obviously this has a huge depth to like John Fahey, I would say. Next is something really special. So next question was folk band. So I go with a band from Italy called Nuova Compagnia di Canto Popolare, the new company of popular singing, which is basically an ensemble of women who were cleaning clothes at the cleaning dwell and singing. So there it is. Pretty magic and voodoo-ish. I was introduced to this with a movie from I believe 1980 called La Pelle, The Skin, with Marcello Mastroianni, a movie about the end of the World War II in Italy, when the Americans were stepping in from the south and were getting help from people who changed sides. And there's a scene, an insane scene, when Marcello Mastroianni introduces some of the American militaries to like a weird party in a bunker by the sea, where there's this troop of women performing this. And this was released on a very strange LP in the 70s, I'm not sure. But this is an unreleased extended 12-inch mix that was only released 5-10 years ago on an Italian label, and it's absolutely stunning. Roberto Di Simone, Second Coro delle Lavandaie. This is a white label, so here's the promo sheet. So he's just singing and drums. Next, a favorite acoustic folk record or musician. Well, one of my two favorites, probably. Of course, we're talking about Robbie Bashel, the only guy who could give John Faye his match, and maybe even a better guitarist, technically, which is insane to say so. Of course, he released quite a few records on Tacoma, John Faye's label, here, the Grail and the Lotus was his first one. Others, and then a few records every in different small labels, but this is my favorite of his. This was released on Vanguard, Zartus. This is from 1974. This one is really good because he sings, but he sings in a very haunted way, and he also plays the piano, the organ. Just a fantastic record. And his voice, I mean, this is... imagine if John Faye could sing like that. Oh my god. Here's what the Italian record looks like, by the way. I think there's another edition of it that you could find. It's not a cheap record anymore, but not crazy expensive either yet, but who knows. Next, after the acoustic, the electric. Your favorite electric folk musician. So we're talking about William Burchett, Wilburn Burchett, later called Master Wilburn Burchett. This is his first or second album. Opens the seven gates of transcendental consciousness. Came with a whole booklet helping you to achieve achieve transcendental consciousness with some images you have to focus on while you listen to the music. Gate 1, gate 2, gate 3. We're listening to gate 3 right now. Came out also with a little booklet, flyer. Don't miss this breakthrough in new stereo vibrations. And it was a private press, so you could order it directly from him, and inside this there's the letter of the person who ordered it, with the response from Wilburn Burchett himself sending it to him. And there's also like a leaflet about Brad Seeger, like a guru. Pretty fun record. I mean, there's tons of other great records of his with a great cover. Psychic meditation music, transcendental music for meditation, the psychic journey of transformation. These were all private presses, and all solo guitar. The Mindstorm, great stuff. Yes, so next, a live record, a live folk record. Well, alright, I had to go there. Probably one of the musicians I've got the most amount of records of. So we're talking about John Fahey, live in Tasmania, Indian Pacific or our blues. This song, I think, was also featured on his reprise album, Songs for the Ball, which I featured in my a contest for Patrick the Vinyl Archivist. Well, you'll hear, like, this is insane level of guitar playing. John Fahey is the founder of Tacoma, the guy who introduced the dissonance in a harmonic way to folk music. Just a pioneer in every possible sense. He's got like a radio show and a record store, if I understand correctly. Did a pretty great video about John Fahey 2 days ago or so. Wow. Oh, his keys. Oh, yeah, and it was pretty good. It mostly tackled the classic John Fahey area, which is late 50s up to early 70s. I will probably do a video about the stuff that comes after, which this is part of. This was released on Tacoma, even if it's got like a pretty boring... Oh, this is so good. Pretty boring cover. But this is from 1980. 81 released. The live is in Sydney from 15 October 1980. Next, the tag was show three folk labels. Well, Mazzy showed the absolute essential, which is, of course, Folkways. Folkways, the record from the first record, Music from the Streets of New York, was on Folkways. Folkways started in the mid-50s. I believe the first release on Folkways is from 1953. And their last releases were up till like 1986 or so. And throughout the history, you got so much stuff from music from all over the world, traditions, avant-garde. This is more on the avant-garde side of things. The entourage, ensemble, music ensemble. But they also released stuff like this. Woody Guthrie, tons of Woody Guthrie, great cover. The cover art of Folkways Records is a huge part of the appeal for me as well. And they had like old records such as this. Music for Pie Contest in Berkeley forms. Such a great label. And another, like, they had kind of a French counterpart called Le Chant du Monde, the singing of the world, or the song of the world, depending on how you want to translate it, which had kind of a very similar output as Folkways. A few, French pressing of records from all over the world, but mostly original stuff. There was a band I wanted to feature, but like you have to make a choice for every category, so I'll just show them the Chant du Monde edition of the Balfa Brothers, which I got many records of. I think here's one, another one, like it's Cajun music, which I love. But this is a French edition. Most of the records on Chant du Monde were gatefolds, with this is a triple fold. Yeah, great stuff. And this label was actually at one point, the art direction was by someone we're gonna talk about very soon. Next, the third folk label is a Swedish label of the Allegiance we were talking about. Folk, psychedelic, hippie, jazz stuff. Huh. We're talking about music, Nätet, MNW. This is Marie Selander from the Svenska Vildmarken, from the Swedish Wild West, in a way, which is folk music, but featuring lots of jazz people that are very cool, like Palle Danielsson, Kjell Westling, Bengt Berger. Yeah, it's a great record, and there's tons of records on the MNW. In the prog, folk, psychedelic styles. So that was three folk labels, which are not purely and exclusively folk, but there you go. Next, Mazzy asked about three records, a record with a protest song, and bonus points in if you showed it from different decades. What is more protest? Who is the most protesting folk in the world? Well, I think I come from that place. So it's France. like there's this thing people used to say, usually say when they go to France on holiday, that France is always on strike, which is kind of true. Like, and one of the most famous strikes was the French Revolution, actually. But let's hear something really dear to me.
Monsieur le Président, je vous fais une lettre que vous lirez peut-être si vous avez le temps. Je viens de recevoir mes papiers militaires pour partir à la guerre avant mercredi soir. Monsieur le Président,
this is Boris Vian.
Je ne suis pas sur terre pour tuer des pauvres gens.
The song is called The Deserter, which is about the French Algerian civil war, where young men in France were required to go make their military service in Algeria during the war. For 3 years. In this song, it's like an open letter to the French president, de Gaulle, where he tells him that he's not gonna do it. He's not on earth to kill poor people. But also, he's French, so he's not gonna defy his culture. So he tells the president he can send the cops after him, and that they can shoot him in the back. He won't be armed. And, well, this is one of the most emotional songs in the whole French culture. It's difficult to listen to this and not get goosebumps when in French. The next one is kind of similar. So, this is almost from the same decade, but this guy is much more known for his 60s protest. In the US, you might know him as the once French boyfriend of Marilyn Monroe. But people who really love movies, they know him as the main actor in all these very political movies from Costa Gavras, Z, all these movies that were denouncing fascism in Greece and South America. And he was a singer at first, before he became an actor. And this is a collection of French popular songs, folk songs, that are all about rebellion. As you can see, this is the Bastille, a battle. And this is a song called The Song of Liberation, which was the singing, the song for the resistance during World War II.
C'est nous qui brisons les barreaux des prisons pour nos frères. La haine à nos trousses et la faim qui nous pousse la misère. Il y a des pays où les gens au creux des lits font des rêves. Ici, nous vois-tu, nous on marche et nous on tue. Nous on crève.
There's a great song called Le Temps des Cerises, which is a song about the French Revolution. La Butte Rouge, the red le temps des cerises, the time of cherry.
Chacun sait cherries. Ce qu'il veut, ce qu'il fait.
La butte rouge, which is the red hill. About the French
ami, si tu commune, un ami,
a popular revolution in the 19th century, the second French Revolution in a way.
Demain, du sang noir séchera au grand soleil sur les routes.
Super violent song.
Chantez, compagnons, dans la nuit, la liberté nous écoute.
Hope and despair at the same time.
Ami, entends-tu les hope because in death qu'on enchaîne,
you might achieve something.
Ami, entends-tu
he was a huge communist, by the way. Yes, you heard it. Marilyn Monroe was dating a French communist. I love this. Now a record on Chant du Monde, who I just talked to you about. Chili, un peuple crève. Chili, a people is dying, is being slaughtered. This is a collection of songs against the dictatorship of Chile from 1974. This is a song of with Colette Magny and Mara. Colette Magny was the art director of Le Chant du Monde.
Correle, correle, correla, correle que te van a matar. Correle, correle, correla.
She plays the guitar as well. She used to be the art director of a French singer called Muruji, also pretty left wing. And just wait for this. This is gonna be insanely.
Su cabeza es rematada por cuervos con cara de oro.
This is a quote song called El Aparecido, written by Victor Jara, Patrice Caratini on bass, great jazz player, and Mara on guitar. Mara is gonna sing in a second.
De la rebeldía lo siguen 20 más 20 porque regala su vida ellos le quieren dar muerte. Correle, correle, correla por aquí, por allá. Correle, correle, correla, correle que te van a matar. Correle, correle, correla, correle que te van a matar. Correle, correle, correla.
Cheap record, by the way.
Hijo de la rebeldía, lo siguen 20 más 20, porque regala su vida. Ellos le quieren dar muerte. Correle, correle, correla, por aquí, por allá. Correle, correle, correla, correle que te van a matar. Correle, correle, correla, correle que te van a matar. Correle, correle, correla.
So Colette Magny was so left-wing that it caused her some problems. She was so, at the extreme left that she was actually banned from the Fête de l'Humanité, which is the French Communist Party fair So she, like, the next question from Mazzy was a blacklisted folk singer. She was blacklisted from the Communist Party because she was too much at the left. And I mean, she was doing records like this on Le Chant du Monde. Repression, where she translated text from the Black Panthers into French and making them into protest songs with the help of great musicians, Beb Guérin, Bernard Vité, François Tusk, Noël Magui, basically the all-star French free jazz, but into a folk jazz context. I mean, this cover is just insane. Next was a question about a British folk artist duo. So this is a British folk duo of Colin Wilkie and Shirley Hard, but with the Albert Mengersdorf and Jockey Freund duo or trio. This is such a stunning record. Wild Goose. So basically, this is like free spiritual jazz and folk. This was released on MPS in Germany. Albert Mengersdorf is one of the most celebrated trombone players of jazz and free jazz. Yeah, so it's the Albert Mengersdorf and Jockey Freund jazz ensemble. And we're listening to Snowy Sunday, Word and Music by Colin Wilkie. Solist Jockey Freund on soprano sax and Emily Mengersdorf on flute. Such a beautiful record. Sorry, I was almost a little bit emotional with the Yves Montand, Boris Vian and Colette Magny stuff. Next, a British folk band. I'm kind of I'm going to cheat a little bit, but not really. So next is Basil Kirshen, who, as many know, hopefully, is one of the greatest library soundtrack producer and musician. And this is so basically he has a band and musicians who play with him for him. And so this is a band, but it is still Basil Kirshen essentially. With the singer is the daughter of the drummer on this song we're gonna listen to. It's basically a demo that was unreleased for years until it was uncovered by Johnny Trunk for his label Trunk Records. First released on this compilation, Fuzzy Felt Folk, a small collection of rare, delightful folk oddities for strange adults and maybe their children too. It was later reissued as an EP with this song and different versions of this song. Sheer beauty. Thank you. you get this weird British kind of pastoral pagan folk music. Like this, you know, the music you would get in movies like what is it called again? The movie with the cult on that island with Christopher Lee, The Wicker Man. This kind of innocent but wicked mood that you can get in some 60s British stuff that you would get also in some punk and post-industrial music. I had to check a little bit. Yes. Next question. A folk rock band. I'm going with one of the best albums ever made in my opinion. Only killer songs, like I think there's like 14 or 15 songs on it. Not a single one is not a classic hit in my opinion. We're talking about, of course, about the Moguls, Les Moguls, a Turkish folk band. This was released in France. Dance and Rhythm from Turkey, from Yesterday and Today by Mogul. We're listening to Sunset in Golden Horn. The Golden Horn Bay near Istanbul derives its name from its characteristic horn shape and from the golden hues reflected from its waters at sunset. That's what this song is about. I didn't know which song to choose. I just had to go with one, but I could play this whole record. But you get a taste for this. Next is a cover of a folk song by a rock pop artist. Isaac.
They call the rising sun. It's been the ruin of many a poor man. And Lord knows I'm one. My mother, she's a tailor. She stitched many blue jeans. My father, he's a gambling man.
I guess this song doesn't need any introduction. So this is a reggae cover, a dub reggae cover of The House of the Rising Sun.
In New Orleans,
and it just takes it in a whole new dimension.
The rising sun.
This is an EP. This is not from the album. It's just a 12-inch record with no artwork.
Of many a poor man.
So Jamaican.
And Lord knows I'm one.
So next, Mazzy was asking that about your favorite. Next is a cover of a song from Bob Dylan. Bob Dylan covered by another band. We're getting there. We're going to Sweden.
So mama, please, tell you
it's horrible to shut this down. To kill this.
Not to do what I've done.
I hope you like this, Roger, if you're watching.
Stay away from the house in New
York. Roger's tallest rider. My reggae man.
They call the rising sun.
So this is Lay, Lady Lay. By the Swedish band called Made in Sweden. Oh, boobs! On a Sonnet, Swedish label. Basically, it's an instrumental cover of of Lay, Lady Lay. This is how the Gregory Isaac record looks like. Such a cool cover. We're getting near the end. Just around the hour mark. Sorry for such a long video. Next, Mazzy was asking about your favorite album cover of a folk record. Well, mine is an artist I already mentioned twice, so maybe I'll show it and then I'll show my second favorite folk cover. This is again Colette Magny, the French protest singer, from her album Enough, Ras la Trompe, Transit. It's a free jazz workshop, which means that she's good. Like Bar Phillips is on bass there, but look at this gorgeous cover. This is how she looks like, smoking lady. Yes, great lineup of people on this record. But to show something else, I'll go back to something maybe more traditional, but at least music-wise, but still one of my favorite covers. Back to Tacoma, Peter Lang. Peter Lang could be sometimes considered as the poor man's John Fahey. occasionally, and especially on this album, he's got songs that buries everyone technically. I think the song is called Snow Toad on this one. Here he is. I got like something like 6-7 albums from his, but this cover, it's kind of, you know, I guess it's from the same artist who did the covers for John Faye's America. But here it is, yeah. The record is fantastic, but like, I'm sure you can imagine, like solo, 6-12 string guitar, great stuff with open tuning. And the last, very last question there. Your favorite folk song? Well, I'm gonna be very honest, but I'm gonna go a little bit on the left field side of things, but honestly, it shouldn't surprise anyone. I'm gonna go with a band, artist not really associated with folk music, but if you think about it, it makes quite a lot of sense. Psychic TV, the second album. Orchids, from Dreams Less Sweet. Again, this British pastoral pagan folk music. This is the project of Genesis P. Orridge from Ringwurzel. This still features Peter Christopherson from Ringwurzel and Psychic TV. This is the limited edition from back then with a limited bonus 12-inch, but all you need is this. There you go, my favorite folk song. What I love about it is how strong the melodies are, the contrast between the wind instruments that give this kind of noble, posh, medieval feeling with this punk singing, like very unpolished, but only concerned about an idea of beauty. The text is pretty well. He's basically describing what's going on down there. But in the most beautiful way. Almost innocent. If you don't listen to the lyrics, you wouldn't get. So there it is. That was my 2021 folk vinyl tag, folks. I hope you enjoyed that. I know it was long, but I dare hope it was worth your while. So I hope you're all good, and please, by all means, write in the comment section down there, and go to Mazzy, see where he went with these questions. I'll put the link down there as well.